people, this is Priyanka from Makeup Magic by Priyanka, and I have teamed up with Shadi Vish to answer some of the most frequently asked questions in makeup. So to answer this question very honestly, I would like to stress upon three things which are going to help a lot for your skincare, and that exercise, rest, and your diet. So believe me, along with all the products or the skincare products that you are using, this has to be mandatory in your lifestyle. You have to exercise well, you have to take enough rest, and you have to take care of what you are eating. That's going to work wonders for your skin. You would not need any facials or anything if you are detoxifying your body in terms of exercises and your diet. Of course, the topical products are important, and you must follow a skincare regime, which is basically essentially just cleansing and moisturizing. Scrubbing once in a week. Apart from that, daily cleansing and moisturizing twice a day, and that will really help your skin a lot. Use products according to your skin type. If you don't need a night cream, do not use it. Don't overload your skin with a lot of products. Consult a specialist. There's loads of information on social media these days, so just choose the products wisely. Some of the brands that are very good for skincare are Estee Lauder. It does wonderful skincare. There are a lot of brands on Nykaa, which has a lot of products, and you can even have a mixed range from natural organic products to the more commercial ones. Tony Moly is one of the brands. It's a Korean brand, but it's excellent for skincare. So yes, but most importantly, I just can't stress enough on sleeping, exercising, and your diet. That you will see how much that helps. You have to be regular, of course, and that you are going to see the difference yourself. There has to be a certain set of rules that needs to be followed. So number one would be, artists have to ensure that they are in perfect health before they visit any bride. It's the moral responsibility of all the artists to make sure they don't have any cold cuff or even a slight fever, no matter what the cause could be. They have to ensure that they are perfectly fit. And apart from that, while being at work, they have to ensure there has to be certain guidelines that need to be followed. For example, there can be only one person, either a family member or a friend of the bride, to be present in the bridal room, in the area where the makeup is happening. No coming and going of relatives or unnecessary crowding of people in the room. Also, that all the makeup tools are washed properly, they have been sanitized properly. So I like to wash my tools and brushes with shampoo and Dettol, and also I sanitize all the makeup products as well, whether it's your lipstick, your kohl pencils, your eye pencils, your lips, your foundation bottles, and everything. The palettes that we use, they all have to be sanitized thoroughly. And also, one thing very important is that the artist that you are booking does not take any other booking for the same day, even though for different timings. So the artist must be visiting just one place and not multiple places for work and then coming to you or however. So there has to be just one artist visiting one place, and so that would control the spread. I think makeup is definitely going to go subtle, as there will be lesser stages, less crowd of people that's seeing you from far away. So makeup can definitely go subtle. We can remove the layers completely. Also, the features have to be defined very well, because anyway we are getting clicked, we are getting pictures. So the features, the sculpting of the face, the highlights and contouring, that has to be taken care of. And the colors that you are using on face have to be very neutral and nudes. about the bridal trends post-COVID, I think since everybody has gone through some or the other kind of evolution in this era, we all have been through something or the other. We all have evolved in some way or the other. So I'm hoping that brides are more open to experimenting now. They can ditch the traditional makeup, the heavy layering, the heavy colors that we use on brides, without which they say that the Indian bride is incomplete. I think that can change totally. Brides should adapt more contemporary way of makeup. They must experiment with colors like sea greens and lilac and peaches, more fresh in the face, and also they shouldn't be blindly copying the other brides or what other artists are doing. They can, according to their personality type, they can definitely have a good discussion with their artists as to what would be best for them. And I'm planning to go on live Zoom sessions with the brides-to-be for their pre-wedding functions so that they can be confident of what makeup they are going to wear. I'm going to help you virtually with your entire makeup look for your engagement or roka. I'm going to see through the products that are available with you, the outfit that you're wearing and what suits your skin, the colors, the texture, how much to put, how much not to put. I'll be guiding all that through online, through Zoom. So yeah, I'm going to send you more details on this. And apart from that, if you choose to do your makeup by yourself for your, say, haldi or other small occasions, I think you should go minimum. You should maybe put on a lip and cheek stain and do your brows well and look natural and as girly as possible and keep the full-fledged makeup for your wedding day. You can add nice metallic shimmery eyeshadows to bring a pop and to enhance the overall look. Don't go cakey or don't layer on the foundations and concealers at your pre-wedding functions, the smaller ones. So yeah, put lots of mascara, put a gloss or something like that. I think they would look very nice for your haldi ceremonies or mehendis.
Hey guys, hit the bell icon and never miss a video from Shadi Wish.